The DNC debates are a world of make-believe.
I don't believe only in reproductive freedom, I believe in reproductive justice.
And if you don't believe in Never Neverland, then you don't get any of the magical powers that comes with being the head of the DNC. And no, I'm not talking about the Michael Jackson one, the Peter Pan one, okay?
You know, what that means is that just because a woman, or let's also not forget, someone in the trans community, a trans female, is poor, doesn't mean they shouldn't have the right to exercise that right to choose.
I think this is what's happening in newsrooms across the world. Everyone gathers around a table and asks each other for ideas. Everyone, too paralyzed to say what they really think, just says the same thing that's culturally acceptable in pop culture. This is why movies are really bad lately, and all we get is superheroes, remakes, and Detective Pikachu. Sorry, Ryan Reynolds. I do love your quips.
What? What's wrong?
No one's allowed to think or say anything different at all. And if someone suspects that you might possibly think differently, then every horrible, nasty, mean thing that could possibly be true about you automatically is, and you are now the enemy. This is why the DNC refuses to have any of their debates on Fox News. This is why whenever any candidate mentioned bridging the gap or visiting red states to try to bring people together, there was virtually no applause. If you don't agree with everything the cult says, then you're automatically a horrible person. Take YouTubers Operation Coldfront, for example. They've been outed as being black and Muslim Republicans, which of course makes them fascists. Now every time they go out to make a video, they have to explain to screeching cult members why they don't deserve to be called racist homophobes.
Ignorant piece of shit.
It's only fair. This is not a conservative channel or a Republican channel. This is a reality channel. And the reality is that the DNC debates were the same thing you've been hearing over and over again on Vox and BuzzFeed every single day.
Sanders, I'll give you 10 seconds just to answer the very direct question. Will you raise taxes for the middle class in a Sanders administration?
People who have health care under Medicare for All will have no premiums, no deductibles, no co-payments, no out-of-pocket expenses. Yes, they will pay more in taxes, but less in health care for what they get.
Who's more offended? Who's more oppressed? Who can give more things away for free? And if you disagree, well, then you're just evil. And for some reason, let's throw in some horrible Spanish, too.
Cada votante necesitamos la representación y cada voz necesitamos escuchar. Este presidente ha atacado, ha demonizado los inmigrantes. Es inaceptable. Voy a cambiar el resto.